Okay, hello, hi, and welcome to the BBC Learning English Live Friday Quiz. My name is Dylan, I'm your host today. Let's have a big hello to anyone who's new here. Hello, thanks for joining us, and a big welcome back to anybody who joined us last week or in the previous weeks. This is our fourth Friday quiz, and it's a music special. Okay. And we've got some great quiz questions for you. We've got vocabulary, phrasal verbs, celebrity quote, and a very special mystery guest. Who could it be? We've had Rob, we've had Catherine, we've had Shan. Who could it be today? Let us know in the comments. Okay, and let's take a look at who we've got here today. So we've got Ingan. Hello, Ingan. Jaganeth, hello. TC, hello, lovely to see you too. And Ketsuda's from Bedford, so not too far away. I am in Liverpool, so not too far. Hello, good afternoon to you all. And Muslim, hello from Wales. So the country is Wales, Welsh is the language and the people. Hello, Muslim. All right, so we're going to begin soon, but before we begin, I'm going to guide you through some of the guidelines for this quiz. There are 8 questions. We do the questions first, and we'll do the answers at the end. So stick around. Questions first, answers at the end. So be sure to stay to find out whether you were right or wrong. Number 2, it is just for fun. There are no prizes. It is Friday. We're relaxing. We're having a nice time together. But it's just for fun. There are no prizes. And number 3, please like, comment, and share. The more of you that are involved, the more fun it will be. The more active you are in your comments and your likes, the more you will benefit from this. Okay, the more active you are in your learning, the more it will stay in your long-term memory, the better it will be for you. Okay, so we're going to start very soon. But before we begin, I'm going to give you a little tip. Many of the questions we look at are based on content from the BBC Learning English pages. So that could be from bbclearningenglish.com. It could be from Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, or here on YouTube. So if you follow us, it will be easier and more beneficial for you. Okay, then, are you ready to begin? Lots of comments saying, yes, ready to begin. So let's get started with the quiz. Okay. So round 1. Okay. Round 1. And when we start the new round, I'm going to go. That means we're moving on to the next round. So round 1. Here we go. Okay. So that's there. Let me just remove that. Ali loves classical music. He hates jazz. Ali loves classical music. He hates jazz. Is it A, although, B, however, C, even though? Ali loves classical music, although he hates jazz. B, however, he hates jazz, or C, even though? Okay, let's take a look into the comment section and see what you are saying. We've got Evaristo. Hello, everyone from Angola, and you'll have all the videos. Great to hear. We've got Taha says A, although. Crystalman says B, however. Maria agrees, however. Alexandra, however. Okay, so lots of different guesses here. And that's it. So go on to question number 2. Okay, so keep your comments coming. We're on to question number 2. All right, and question number 2 is about a common expression or phrase. And it goes like this. So, as I said, it's a music theme today here on the BBC Learning English Live Quiz. I'm going to fill the blank. You're not such a great singer. Yourself. Get into yourself, A. B, get out of yourself. Or C, get over yourself. So which of these means to not think you're so important, to not think you're so amazing or so great? Is it get into yourself, get out of yourself, or get over yourself? What could it be? So let's have a look into the comment section and see what you are thinking today. So who's coming up here? Wow, so many comments coming in. Amina says, see, get over yourself. Sorry, you can't pronounce that name. It's saying get into. Gaming Master saying get out of. So a bit of a variety. So I think that this is a little bit of a tough question for you guys. So be sure to stick around for the answer. Remember, we do the questions first. I will stick around and do the answers. We'll do the answers at the end. Okay. On to question number three. Okay. So here we go. Oops. And we've got a bit of a classic grammar question. This is a grammar question that many students and English language learners find a little bit difficult, okay? But you want to choose which of these is the correct word or words to go in the blank space. Jimmy, guitar since 2005. He is great. Jimmy, guitar since 2005. He's great. Is it A, played? Jimmy played. Is it B, has played? Jimmy has played guitar. Or is it C, Jimmy had played guitar since 2005. He is great. So, bit of a tough grammar question here. We've got three has played. Okay, so choice B, do you agree? Intan agrees. Felix agrees. So lots and lots of people saying B for this one, but make sure you stick around until the end where we go through the answers. If you'd like to learn more about grammar, if you're not sure about this question, be sure to go to bbclearningenglish.com where we've got loads and loads of great grammar content. If you want to go on YouTube, 6-Minute Grammar, BBC Learning English, we've got loads about this topic and many others. Okay, moving on quickly. Question number four. Round four. Okay, let's get rid of this. Let me just remove that. Okay. So, Marco ran Julia at the concert last night. They hadn't seen each other for ages. So we're looking for the correct phrasal verbs. Now, we do a lot of phrasal verbs here at BBC Learning English. And if you are on Facebook, Twitter, or on Instagram, we do five new phrasal verbs every Friday morning. It's a lovely table that we put out with lots of questions. So some of you might have seen this recently if you follow us on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. Marco ran Julia. And this means they met each other. Which of these means met? Okay. So we got Sullivan says B, for. Thew says into. Mohammed says C. Sorry, I can't pronounce your name again. It's for. So again, a little bit of variety. So this is nice. I love seeing a question where there's a bit of conflict between the students. You're not sure because it means there's a great opportunity for you to learn. Okay, and we got Aziza says B. Okay, so lots of variety in the answers there. Be sure to stick around. We've got 8 questions. We'll do the questions first, and then we'll do the answers after that. Okay, and the next question, round number 5, is our special mystery guest. Now, could you guess who might it be this time? We've had Catherine, we've had Rob, and we've had Sian. Who could it be this time? Any guesses into the comment section? Let's take a look. No guesses yet. Keep them coming. All right, let's introduce. Oops, sorry, everybody. Technical issues. So many comments coming so fast. Okay, let's introduce our guest. And dun, 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 dun.
Hello. Hi. Hello. Hello, everyone. Oh, there's loads of people watching. Excellent. It's the music quiz today, yeah, Dylan. Is that right?
Ta-da. Yeah, like, see, you've come prepared.
I can't play anything. I mean, this is just a toy. I'm rubbish. I can't play the guitar.
Yeah, but I believe you're a big music fan.
I love music. I love listening to music. I'm obsessed. With it. But no, I can't play anything, sadly. Yeah, I love it.
So you're not going to wow our audience with a master hit?
I think it would hit your viewing figures really badly. I think everyone would turn off. They'd be running away to turn it off as soon as they can. So
down they go.
I'm going to be kind. I'm not going to touch it now.
So we'll stick with your area of expertise, which is English.
Okay, yes.
I believe you've got a vocabulary question for us.
Yes, and it is music related, and it's a word. I think it's a word we use quite a lot. You might not see it in that many textbooks, or you might not have learned it at school, but the word we're looking at today is gig. We're looking at the word gig, G-I-G, just three letters. And the question I've got is, what does it mean? What is a gig? Is it A musical instrument like this one here? Is it B, an event, somewhere you could go to? Or is it C, something that a rock star might wear? I don't know, maybe it's a hat, something like that.
Okay.
So is it A musical instrument, B, an event, or C, something a rock star might wear?
Okay, thank you, Phil. It's a great question. And I think it's a particularly good question because, as you say, it's a word that's very commonly used in Britain and amongst native speakers, but we hear it less often amongst our learners and English language learners, really, don't we?
Well, until today, now everyone will know what it means. They'll be using it all the time.
Perfect. Absolutely. So, Phil, I can see lots of comments here where they are saying hello and they're very pleased to see you.
Oh, fantastic. Hi to everyone. I say we've got loads of people watching. That's great. It's good to see people from all over the world. I love to see that.
It's fantastic, isn't it? So lots of them are asking, where can they see you next, or when can they see you? What's going on with you?
Well, it's funny you should ask that, because next Wednesday I'll be doing a live lesson exactly the same time as this. So that's 1:30 UK time, Greenwich Mean Time. And I'll be doing a lesson on countable and uncountable nouns for food. So do make sure you've had your lunch or your dinner beforehand, otherwise you'll get hungry while you're watching.
great. So that's Wednesday, 1:30, Facebook and YouTube, is that correct?
Yes, yeah.
Phil, thank you very much for joining us and for asking such a great question.
Thanks for having me, Dylan.
Okay, yeah. See you again. Bye-bye.
Bye. Take care.
Okay, that was Phil, everybody. And Phil had a really nice question for you. Could you let us know what is the correct answer? A, instrument, B, event, or C, something that you wear? What is a gig? So we've got, I should say. Hi, sorry, the comments are loading up quite slowly today. So let's take a look. So excuse me if it's a little bit slow. Rita says B, an event. We've got Bun, or Gaming Master and Bun say A. And we've got, let's take a look. Mauricio says event. So a few people say an event, and some other people guessing instrument or something that a rock musician would wear. So let's move on to question 6. Okay, so let's take a look again. Question number 6. Oops. So let's. Question number 6. All right. So this is question number 6 of the BBC Learning English live Facebook and YouTube quiz on Fridays. And we've got a very, we've just had Phil, our special guest. Now we're going to look at what a celebrity has said, a celebrity question. And we're looking at Rihanna. So on Saturday mornings, we have a quote of the week where we look at something that a famous person or celebrity has said. On Saturday, we looked at a phrase on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter that Rihanna has said. And she said, I don't care size, shape, or color. What did you say? I don't care about. I don't care about. I don't care by. Or I don't care for size, shape, or color. What do you think the correct answer could be? So, Eduardo says about. Shazia says about. Lata. Oh, Mohammed says about. Somebody called Lata. Hi, Lata. You said by. So a little bit of variety. I don't care by. I don't care for. Or I don't care about. On to question number 7. Okay. Question number 7. Ah, we've got an idiom questions. And here at BBC Learn English, we love idiom questions. Okay, we love idioms and we post them on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter all the time. But here we're looking at the idiom, make a song and dance about something. And you might have noticed that now there are no multiple choices. I'm going to leave this open little experiment and you tell me the answer. Okay, so I'm not going to give you a choice. You're going to type it in because being more active in your learning will help you. And also it gives you a greater variety so that you can put down the answer that you feel is correct. Okay. Yeah. Some people are saying I've spilt the beans on the last question. But stick around at the end. We'll discuss the correct answer and why and how we came to that answer. But all right then. So let's take a look. We've got Shani with a nice guess, meaning enjoy your life. Oops. Grizel says, don't worry about something. Or we got a very nice answer from Jolanta. It says to exaggerate or build up the importance of something more than necessary. We got 1K subscriber says extreme excitement. Oh, I'm liking this open question. Lots of interesting answers here. To do what you want, says Saul. When you manage something by yourself. So a very nice variety of questions. Unnecessary fuss. Have fun, says. Oh, Bitwan says making an unnecessary fuss. Okay, so stick around. We'll do the answers soon. On to question number 8. The last of our questions. And then we will look at the answers. The answers very soon. Okay. Round 8. And this is a question I like because I love music. And I love many different types of music. And we can call types of music a genre of music or genre of music. But which of these is not a genre of music? Pop, ska, reggae, blues, reds, or funk? Which of these is not a genre of music? Pop, ska, reggae, blues, reds, or funk? And let me know, what is your favorite genre of music? I like rock and electronica. That's my favorite. What's your favorite style of music or favorite genre? So we've got Amita says, I think reds and EOB. So that's reds or ska from Tamila. Many people saying reds. So not many people have heard of reds. Saina says, I'm into pop, as does Prayas. Okay, so very nice. We've got, sorry, Mauritius is a fan of ska. Okay, so we've got some people maybe giving you a bit of a clue about which are and which aren't real genres of music. Okay then, so. Okay, that is the question section done. Now we're going on to the important part, which is the answers, okay? So don't just do the questions and go. This is the important part. And if you have enjoyed or you are enjoying, please hit that like button. It all helps, okay? So are you ready for the answers? All right, so we've got answers coming up. Let me know, how many do you think you have got correct? So take a guess, okay? How many do you think you've got correct so far? All right, then, everybody having a good time? I am. All right, round one. So round one was our first question, obviously, and it was asking about a bit of a grammar question. Ali loves classical music, although he hates jazz, however he hates jazz, or even though he hates jazz. So I'll just remove that so you can see it clearly for a second. Okay, I'm going to take a look at the answer, which is however. Okay, so the correct answer is B, however. Yes, so you might have seen this recently on Facebook, Instagram, where we looked at synonyms for but, which we put out on Wednesday, I believe. And we use however when we're showing a contrast between two different items. So, for example, I love dogs. However, I don't like cats so much. Or I thought the job interview went really well. However, I didn't get the job. Or in this case, Ali loves classical music. However, he hates jazz. So we often use however at the start of a new sentence with a comma, and we join two independent clauses or sentences together. Although and even though do show contrast, but they are usually used to start a dependent clause, and you can think of this as needing two pieces of information in the one sentence. Okay, although I was really angry, I tried to hide it. Okay, so let me know, did you get that correct? Who got that? Okay, 1 point from Ophel. Hooray, hooray, hooray. I assume that means that you got the correct answer. Yay. Huh. Gaming Master asks, what is jazz? So jazz is a genre of music. So it's a type of music. It was very popular in between the 30s and 50s. It came out of America. It's got lots of different instruments, so there'll be a saxophone player, a trumpet player, Duke Ellington or Miles Davis are famous jazz musicians. Okay, round two. Aha. So, lots of people got question one right. Did you get question number two? So, you're not such a great singer. Yourself. Get into yourself, get out of, or get over yourself. What could it be? Okay. Let's have a look. And the answer is, of course, get over yourself. So get over yourself is an expression or phrase that you can use when you think that somebody is too serious or that they think that they're really important. Do you know, they kind of walk, yeah, I'm so awesome. They think they are fantastic. So in this example, the person thinks, oh, wow, yeah, I can sing, but maybe they're not so good, or maybe people don't want to listen to them, or they're too arrogant. So you say, get over yourself. Stop taking yourself so seriously. Stop thinking you're so great. Get over yourself. Now, did you get that correct, everybody? What's your score so far? So we got Thotmeyer says two correct. So your comment has disappeared. Thotmeyer says two correct. We've got Emmy, get over, not quite. So let's take a look. Two questions. We got, is it, aha, not really sure how to see an answer. I was close. Close, but not quite, huh? All right. And we've got Evgeny, correct. All right. Me, yes, well done, Ahmed. Okay. So let's move on to question number three. Okay, and question number three was our grammar question. And it asked, Jimmy, guitar since 2005. He is great. So he's still playing because he is great. Jimmy played guitar. Jimmy has played, or Jimmy had played. Okay, so the important information is here. He's great. He is great, so he's still playing now. So because he's still playing now, the correct answer is B, has played. Yes. Okay, so B, has played, is an example of the present perfect. And we use the present perfect with for or since to talk about an activity that started in the past, but that is continuing now. It can't be A, because that's the past simple, and that suggests he does not play anymore. But we've said he's great. It can't be C, because that's the past perfect. The past perfect refers to a time earlier than before, and we use it to make clear that one event happened first or before another in the past. So we could say, Jimmy had played piano for 5 years before he started playing guitar, but we cannot use it here. So the correct answer is B. Did you get it correct? Shruti, well done. 2 points so far. Good job. I agree with you. Good. Glad to hear it. Okay. Gaming Master, 2 out of 3. He's still playing guitar. Yes. So the answer should be has played. The present perfect. Okay. Question number 4. We are flying through this. How many have you got so far? Let's have a look. Samuel, don't worry. We're all here to learn. Okay, 0 out of 3 so far. There's still 5 more questions to go, and they're quite tough. The important thing for all of you is to remember that you are learning. Even if you didn't get it correct, you are learning, and then next week, we'll try and get a better score, and we're improving our English. Okay, so question number 4. On the BBC Learning English Live Friday quiz. Okay, so we've got Marco ran Julia at the concert last night. They hadn't seen each other for ages. So Marco ran Julia at the concert last night. Now, what could it be? Ran down, ran for, or ran into? And phrasal verbs is an area that many students, English learners, find frustrating or difficult. But if you'd like to improve your phrasal verbs and your skills, be sure to follow us on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. Every Friday morning at 6 a.m. UK time, we put out a lovely phrasal verb table with 5 phrasal verbs, and it will really help. If you can learn those 5 every week, it will go up and up, and you learn all the phrasal verbs soon enough. Okay, so the correct answer was ran into. Now, ran into means to bump into somebody unexpectedly, to meet somebody without planning to. So if Marco ran into Julia, that means that they didn't plan to meet, but they saw each other at the event, at the concert. Okay, so that's ran into. Did you get that correct? Oh, we've got Akishino, run into, come across. Yes, okay, very similar. Class 10A10, correct from Vietnam. Okay. Siowu, 4 out of 4. Well done. And Pink Dream for you as well. Awesome. Awesome job, guys. Well done if you've got it. If you haven't got 4 out of 4, don't worry. As I've said, we're here to learn. We're here to improve, to get better together. Okay. So question number 5. And one more time, if you are enjoying, please hit that like button, okay? Hit like, hit share, make your comments, big thumbs up if you're enjoying, okay? So round 5 was Phil's question. Whoops. Okay, and Phil asked the question, what is a gig? And a gig is a common word. We use it all the time in the UK. It's popular in America too. And is it used to describe an instrument, an event, or an item of clothing that a rock star might wear? Is a gig an instrument, an event, or an item of clothing? And the correct answer is an event. Yes. Okay. So a gig is a really useful word, as I mentioned, and it's quite an informal word for a live show or concert. So it's particularly common if there's a smaller artist and they're playing in a local club or a local bar, a small venue. A show or concert makes you think of something very big. Okay, but if it's quite a small show, we can call it a gig. We can also call a big show a gig. Okay, but gig implies maybe a little bit smaller, maybe a few hundred or a few thousand people, or a concert or a show might mean something a bit larger. Gig, very common informal word to describe a live show, a live musical show of some sort. Did you get that correct? So how many have you got? All right, we've got Juan, did not know it. Great. Well, you're here to learn. Something to learn then. All right. Pink Dream is 5 out of 5. We've got Georgina's happy to learn. Ooh, yes. Okay, good. Good, good, good. Let's have a look. An instrument. No, it's not an instrument. It's a live event. Okay. Can you say an example with the word gig? Says Mariana. Yes, I can. So today is the 12th of March. Exactly 1 year ago today, I went to my last gig. I went to see a gig by a musician called John Hopkins in the Albert Hall in Manchester. He's a great musician. And he played a great set, but that was the first day, or that was the last day I went to work before the pandemic, before the COVID situation got very serious, before lockdown. And that was the last time I went to a gig. So Mariana, when was the last time you went to a gig? Okay, so when was the last time you went to a live show? When was the last time you went to a gig? Tariq, 5 out of 5, great. Mohammed has asked a nice question. Thank you for asking, Mohammed. You've joined the class for the first time. What's the exact time of the classes? It is on Friday at 1:30 UK time. Okay, moving on. Round 6 was a question about something Rihanna has said recently. And this is something we put out Saturday mornings, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. It's a lovely little vocabulary table where we look at words taken from celebrities or famous people or singers. Now, some of you noticed that I might have spilled the beans, let the answer out. So I expect lots of you to get this answer correct, where it is about. I don't care about size, shape, or color. So she said this, and it means that she doesn't care about something. It means, of course, it means that it's not important to somebody. It's not relevant. I have no strong feelings or emotions about it. So, for example, for me, I don't care about Rihanna's new album. I don't like pop music. Or you could say, I don't care who wins the election. I'm not interested in politics. So we use don't care about for things that we think are unimportant. So what do you think is unimportant? Can you use an example yourself? We use don't care for to talk about things we don't like. So I don't care for ice cream. It hurts my teeth. Not really. I love it. Or from an earlier example, Ali doesn't care for jazz. He prefers classical. Okay, so that's how to use that there. That is question 6. Oh, Ahmed, your comment is gone, but Ahmed says he's going to see a gig tomorrow. I'm very jealous. We're still in lockdown in the UK and I miss gigs. It's one of the things that I haven't seen in exactly a year. So I'm very, very much looking forward to that. Okay, class 10 here. You're so funny. Where are you from? I am from Wales in the UK. So I'm Welsh, but I live in Liverpool. Let's have a look. I don't care about what people say about me. Lovely example, Ahmed. Okay. Mohammed says, I don't care about fear. FS Shahal says, please do more of these. Every Friday, 1:30, Facebook and YouTube, 1:30 UK time, you can catch us. All right then. So, Mohammed, 4 out of 6, good job. All right. Question number 7. And question number 7 was about the idiom, make a song and dance about something. Okay, so what does that mean? And we had lots of great answers from many, many people, okay, last time. And the correct answer, I'm going to give you my definition. So with this one, you might have a slightly different answer, but as long as you get the main idea, you can take that off as 1 point. Okay, so if you make a song and dance about something, you overreact. You make something seem more important than it actually is. So you take a small thing and you make it into a big thing. So I'll give you 2 examples. Every morning before school, Zainab's daughter makes a song and dance about going to school. So that means that she gets up and I don't want to brush my teeth. Brush your teeth. I don't want to eat my cereal. Okay, they complain and they make everything into a big fuss, even though it's just a small job, really. Another example, even when the teacher, I'm very familiar with this, even when the teacher gives their students a little bit of homework, they make a huge song and dance about it. Oh, teacher, oh no, teacher, I don't want to. Okay, they make a big deal out of something that is only small. So did you get that correct? Okay, so we had, let's have a, whoops, don't care about life. Sorry to hear that, Zubai. If you're not feeling so good, check out our 6-minute English on loneliness on YouTube. It's really a big help. So we've got 1K subscribers, 6 out of 7. Pooja, overreact, exactly that. Oh, Offel, love to hear it. Yeah, storm in a teacup, yes. A big deal about something that's only small, really. Vera, now I know the meaning. Happy to help. That's why we're here. That's why we're all here together, yeah? Okay. So, round 8, a final question. Here we go. Right, round 8. Aha, and this is my favorite question. Favorite question. Technology has jumped ahead. And it asks, which of these is not a genre of music? And the correct answer is reds. So pop, ska, reggae, blues, and funk are all genres of music. Okay. And remember, a genre is a style or category of music, art, or literature. So my favorite genre of films is action. You might like sci-fi or romance or horror. In music, there are lots of genres. We've got pop music, which is short for popular music. And this is the type of music you hear on the radio, which young people like. Rihanna makes pop music. Ska and reggae are both genres of music that came from Jamaica in the 1950s and 60s. So you might know Bob Marley was a very famous reggae artist. The Specials in the UK, very nice ska band. The blues came from America about 150 years ago. And it's had a big influence on pop and rock and many other forms. Jimi Hendrix, B.B. King, Eric Clapton. And then funk, you might know because it's very upbeat. Lots of sound from the guitar. And you might know it from James Brown. He's probably the most famous funk musician. So those are all real genres. Reds is not. It's the blues, not the reds. Okay, right then. So, time to know. How many did you get correct? Oh, going back, sorry. What does gig mean? Gig is a live concert or event. This is question number 5. Gig is a live concert or event. Reds are Manchester United soccer team. Boo, boo. Liverpool all the way. Vero. Likes pop music. Ska sounds weird. It's quite an unusual word, I suppose, but a great genre. Mohammed, great. So you're in the right place to practice British English. Perfect place to study. 5 out of 8, good. 75%, I think that's a good result too. Margarita, 8 out of 8. Yes, love to hear it. Blues harmonica is very, very cool. I love the sound of the blues harmonica. wow, wow, wow. Yeah, I love it. I tried to learn myself, but I wasn't very good. Okay, let's have a look. We've got Yilin, 7 out of 8. In Vietnam, there's a genre called red. Really? Well, I've never heard of this before. After this, I'll have a look and have a listen to Vietnamese reds music. All right. Right. Okay, then, everyone. That is the end of today's quiz. So thanks for joining us. Thanks, Intan. Okay. And remember, check us out, bbclearningenglish.com. I've told you many times. Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube, of course. So check us out there. We have live lessons Wednesdays at 1:30 UK time. So check Phil out there, and you can catch Sian and Charlotte, many other teachers, Wednesdays at 1:30. You can catch me on Fridays at 1:30 British time. Put it in your calendars, get your phones, set your reminders, put it in your diary, and I'm going to see you next week. Okay, and I'll just stay and we'll have 2 minutes saying goodbyes. So thank you, Athena. Hi, Crystal. Hello in Myanmar. Samuel, thanks for joining us. Thanks for all your comments. I saw lots of them coming up. Let's take a look. Yilin, thank you. Umi, yes. Now, thank you so much, teacher. You're welcome. Okay, we're here to help. We love, if you're having fun, I'm having fun. Okay, so good evening, or good afternoon, or or good night, or whatever the time is with you. Bye-bye, and we'll see you same time next week. Bye.